See, we have four murals since we have six offers, and two are from Penang, two are from Shah Alam, the one number 67. Okay, the first one is a literature of the bicycle case in Penang. The artist is Ernest Zakharovic, the Lithuanian born artist. He has been in Penang and also in Teoh. Basically, when he was in Penang, he was going through this project that is known as the Mirrors of Georgetown, where what they're trying to do is to transform the streetscape of Georgetown. So basically, what he has done, he has painted a lot of different kind of murals, 3D murals in Georgetown, and this was done during the Georgetown Festival in 2012.
So are we talking about the four concepts, different from someone else. The first concept that you can take from this mural is figure and ground. Figure being the focal point of the mural art, which is the bicycle, because it's a three-dimensional object. So even though the mural depicts two children on a bicycle, but your focus goes straight to the bicycle itself instead of the children. So in this case, the ground will be the children. Next concept is non-verbal codes being facial expression. And as you can see, the young girl is smiling, showing joy. And for the younger brother, with his eyes closed and mouth open, he can show both excitement as well as anxiety. Because, you know, when you go on the bicycle ride, right? The next concept is touch. Touch is a way in which people communicate and interact via the sense of touch. And in this mural art, it conveys physical intimacy between the two siblings as the younger brother is hugging the sister from behind. And the fourth one is concept of space. In this case, the space concern is infinite space because they are close to each other in less than 6 inches. It's also known as closed space. So the next one will be completed by Vicky.
The non-verbal communications, as you see, the young boy is leaning against the girls and shows that they are really close, so they are siblings.
So next one will be the brother and sister. This is the brother and sister of the swing. This is by Louis Gunn, which is also a deaf male artist. Basically, he taught himself how to actually get involved into art. He was also from Penang, and he was born deaf because of his mother German measles. And until now, he's still a freelance artist, but mainly what he does is he does watercolor and acrylic, but then he does want to venture into using oil paintings in his future mirrors time.
Both the children is less than 18 meters, so inches, and that shows the close relationship that they are both comfortable to each other. And the next one is non-verbal communication. We are talking the posture of the both children standing on the swing and they are close to each other. The third one is perception process. Closure means the tendency to feel the missing involved in order to complete one segment. In this mural, I'm acting at the finish of this mural. If I'm not standing there, the girls will be looking at an empty space. So,
I'll be talking about the social expression. So you can see that the brother and sister, they have their mouth turned upwards and slightly closed eyes. So this can indicate that they are actually very happy playing on the swing. And the next one is complementary relationships. Both of them, like brother and sisters, they have different personalities and all that, so they are very different individuals. But then here you can see that even though they have their differences, they still share the same interests because they enjoy playing the swing together.
Next one is the facial expressions. This mural is in number 77 Shah Alam. This is by Kamal bin Muhammad Idris. this mural art is actually from a competition held by the MDSA, Majlis Madrasah Syahalam, and also in collaboration with the Hazana Studio. Basically, what they are trying to do is to actually beautify the back lane, because the connotative meaning of back lane is like very dirty and it's filled with bad people and so on. So what they're trying to do is to change the connotative meaning of it. So what they're trying to do is to initiate a project to beautify the back lane. That's why they call it Lorong Pelaka. So for this mural art, there's not so much info on the artist itself. But what he did was he left a mark on the lower right corner, which is an icon. So that's it.
So the first concept for this facial expression mural art is the non-verbal communication. Here we'll talk about the gesture instead. So here we can see that the people in the mural have their hands close to their mouth over there. This is like to indicate that they are either like trying to move, like they are moving somewhere like that, and then they are trying to conceal it. And then for the next one, my first impression of this mural art is that they are like something sneaky is actually going on around them because they are like smoking and like.
Talking about facial expression, in the picture they are all in a similar motion. And the perception process is that they are looking in the same direction and Nurin is looking at a different direction and filling up the space. A small group communication in the mirror experience a state of attention as an proposed same action.
So the last mural is the smoker's mask. This is done by it's by Shafiq Rashid bin Abdul Jalil. It's the same thing as the one which what they're trying to do. It's also the same project to initiate a project to beautify the place. This mural art is to show awareness to people because basically in this space, which is section 7, inshallah, there are many smokers around there. So he tries to actually have this mural art there as a message, awareness message to them. For this, you only left mark of a handprint bottom right as his initial, and also this is the year which is 2014.
A smoker may look healthy on the outside but not inside. The artist is using steak and choose healthy to let the audience to know that it's positive.
The second concept is passive expression. It's actually a way of understanding of something and become aware to sense. By looking at this mural, it has become an awareness to the audience. Next is semantics language. For the words and language here, is individual words, it has a multiple meanings such as in but not inside. Inside can refers to mentally or physically. Next is first impression. Our first impression, for the first time we're looking at this mural, we immediately thought about smokers because we're already implying in our brain that lungs and smokers has something related. In a way that the artist succeed in interpreting the mural in what he wanted to create. And the last one is somebody in Nurinism. It's actually a process of development of self through the message that from others received from others. Through this mural, it opens up the smoker's eyes to know that smoking is very harmful to themselves or to other people. So in a way, they will get the information to their brain and they will slowly, eventually will think about it and they will quit smoking in the future.
So basically that's the all four murals that we have. So yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you.